In this video, we're going to answer the question, what is a radian? So to motivate the topic, let's say that you wanted to measure the following curve. So we're going to measure this curve using little line segments. And let's say that the line segment that we're interested in using is this long. So we'll label this little line segment L. And I'm going to ask myself, using this little measuring stick, if you will, how many L's do I have in this curve? Well, let's see. Just like you'd measure a curve on a map. So I'd say maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5, and pretty close to 6 L's. So what I can do is if I label this entire curve, if I label the length of the curve S, I notice that if I take S and I divide it into line segments that are this length L, well, how many do I get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I get 6 of those. Okay? So we're going to do the same thing, but instead of using a curve, we're going to use a circle. So let's go ahead and draw a circle here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw in the radius of the circle, R. And I'm going to now measure an arc that is a curve, if you will, along the outside of the circle. Okay? So I'm going to start right here at this point that corresponds to what's called the initial ray, or the initial side, and I'm going to, starting here, I'm going to move the point around, and then I'm going to, by doing that, I'm going to generate an arc. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're here, we move along, and let's say I stop there. And then I ask myself, after that movement, so here's my arc, I'm labeling that S. How long is this? Now, in the previous example, I had a curve and I used this little L as my sort of measuring stick, if you will. In this example, what's the natural measuring stick for the circle? And the circle sort of has one built into it, and it's its radius. So I'm going to look at the radius as the measuring stick in the same way that I looked at L as the measuring stick for the curve up here. So I can ask myself, in this arc, which I'm labeling S, how many radii do I have starting here? So again, here's my measuring stick. I can go through, I'd say maybe that's 1 radius right about there, and then I keep going, and then maybe there's a second one. So in the same way that I saw the curve as having 6 little line segments L, or being composed of 6 line segments L, I can see this arc S as being composed of 1, 2 little radii. In the same way that S divided by L is 6, here for the circle, S divided by, well, in this case, R, because that was what I was using as my measuring stick, would be equal to 2. Now what's interesting about this is that I generated this arc through a rotation. And you can view it as taking this initial side and rotating it and ending up with what we call the terminal side. So I had this sense of rotation. So that rotation generated this arc. Now, it turns out that this process is independent of the circle that you draw. So let me draw another circle with a smaller radius. Okay? So here's the radius of this circle, and let's do the same thing. Let's start at this point, and let's move through 2 radii. Now, the radius here is smaller than the radius over there. So when I move through 2 of these radii, I'm not going to move quite as far. That is, I'm going to generate a smaller arc because the radii are smaller, or the radius here is smaller. But let's go ahead and do it and see what we get. So starting here, I'm going to move through 1, which maybe is right about there. So that's 1 radius. And then if I move through another, I get maybe to right about here. So this was my measuring stick, right? I move through one, and then I move through two, and I generated an arc length. And then if I draw in the terminal side, this denotes my rotation. And once again, I can see that if I take the arc length, that is the S, and I divide it by the radius, once again, by design, in this case, I get 2. Now what's important to notice in both of these circles is that the amount of rotation was the same. That is, this angle, which we're going to call theta, is the same as this angle, theta. And so that's always going to be the case. For any circle that you draw, if you use the radius as its measuring stick and you move through two radii, you're always going to get this angle. You're always going to get this amount of opening. Okay? And so that's why we have a new way of defining an angular measurement. The angle theta can always be looked at as the quantity or the ratio of the arc length divided by the radius for any circle that you draw. Now when you measure an angle in this way, that's called calculating the radian measure of the angle. So radian measure. That's our definition of radian measure. So in the previous examples, I just illustrated what it looks like when the radian measure is 2, right? The quantity or the ratio was, well, S divided by R, and I got 2. What would happen if somebody asked you to calculate or to graph the angle with radian measure 4? Let's go ahead and try that. So let's say we wanted to graph theta equals 4 radians. Okay, so that word radians tells me it's a new way of measuring an angle. What you do is you draw a circle of any size that you want, and once you've done that, you've determined a radius. And that radius is your measuring stick. And what you do is you, starting here, you create an arc where that arc is composed of four of these radii. So let's go ahead and do it. So starting here, well, there's maybe one, and then I keep going, and here's a second one, and then I go a little bit further, and here's maybe my third one, and I go for another one, and there we go. And where I end up, that's my terminal side. So this amount of rotation, that would be called, well, that's an illustration of an angle with 4 radians. And the reason is because the arc is 1, 2, 3, 4 of these measuring sticks. That is 4 of these radii. That's what we mean when we say an angle of 4 radians. It's that amount of rotation for any given circle. Now, there are certain angles that are very interesting to us. And see, over here, in this problem, we were just given the angle 4 radians, but you could turn it around. You could say, well, how many radians are in a certain arc length? So for example, I could ask the question, how many radians are in an arc length of, let's go with C, the circumference. Okay, so let's go ahead and illustrate what that problem is asking. They're saying, okay, if you draw a circle, and once again, you start at your initial side, Well, the arc length is the entire circumference. So you start here, and how far do you go around? Well, you go all the way around, right? So here I'm going like so. This is my arc length all the way around. And I end up where I started. Now the question is, well, what is that arc length? What is going all the way around? Well, it's the circumference, but what is the circumference of a circle? Well, in this case, S is the circumference, and the circumference of any circle is 2 pi times the radius of the circle. So the angle we're talking about, which I'm denoting like this, theta, right? That full rotation, that angle theta, according to our definition, well, it's always the arc length divided by the radius. That's the definition of the radian measure. But in this case, the arc length is the circumference that is all the way around. So the S is actually 2 pi r. And then I divide that by my r, and I end up getting, because the r's now cancel, I end up getting 2 pi. So that's my angle in radians. So that's an interesting result, because you know that if you have a circle and you rotate all the way around, there's another way of measuring that amount of rotation. After all, isn't that 360 degrees? Well, what we're seeing here is that 2 pi radians is the same thing as 360 degrees. And that's an important connection, because it connects the two ways of measuring an angle. You can either have 2 pi radians or 360 degrees. They represent the same amount of rotation. Now, if you think about that, what that implies is that you can create a chart that connects radians to degrees. Why? Well, we already know one entry, right? We know that 2 pi radians is the same as 360 degrees. But now imagine not rotating 360 degrees. Imagine rotating half of that. Well, 180 degrees. And what would happen over here with the radian measure? Well, instead of rotating, you know, all the way 2 pi r, that is the circumference, you'd be rotating half of the circumference, because you're only going, instead of going 360 degrees, you'd be going, instead of going all the way around, you'd be going only, you know, 180 degrees, but I can see that 180 degrees is the same thing as half of the circumference. But of course, half of the circumference means that instead of having 2 pi r, you're only going to have pi r. You're only going to have half of that. And then the r's will cancel, and you have half of 2 pi. That is, you have pi. So 180 degrees is the same as half of the circumference divided by r, which is pi radians. And likewise, you can continue in this manner. That is 90 degrees. Instead of pi, well, it's only half of that, and that would be pi over 2. And then 45 degrees would be pi over 4. And then it turns out that you could create a couple more angles that are really useful. 30 degrees. That turns out to be pi over 6 radians. And then finally, 60 degrees. That's equal to pi over 3 radians. So there are two major ways of representing rotation. The one way is using degrees that you have been using probably your whole life. And now the other way is using what we call the radian measure of an angle. Now, of course, you can use this in an application. So if you were snowboarding, for example, you could say, oh, yeah, I rotated 360 degrees. Or you could say to your friend, I rotated 2 pi radians. So be looking for that in the next Winter Olympics when people talk about, you know, snowboarding. Maybe they say, oh, he did a 180. Maybe in the future they'll say, he or she did a pi radian rotation. And that's what it means to have, or that's the meaning of radian measure.